Very good morning all of you. Now welcome to lecture number 10. In lecture number 10 we are going to see error detecting and correcting codes. In digital system, when the digital information is transferred from one place to other place, and digital information like you have a sender and you have a receiver, a digital data is transferred from one place to other place, so there is a probability for your binary bits may change to 0 to 1 or 1 to 0. This leads to error in the binary data. It can be a 1 bit error or more than that. So, for our syllabus concern, we are going to see how to detect 1 bit error and correct 1 bit errors. This is our syllabus constraints. So we'll be just checking how to find out a 1 bit error in a given data which is received from the sender side and how to correct it at the receiver side. So in order to do this, we have two kinds of parity codes are two kinds of codes which are available. One is parity code, second one is Hamming code. In parity code, we are going to detect only single bit error, no correction. We are not going to do any correction. No correction can be done. It's only for the detection. No correction can be done. Whereas in Hamming code, we are going to detect and correct the single bit errors. Now we'll see how to do this by a parity code and Hamming code. Now we'll start with the parity code. Please remember, when the digital data is transferred, let's take same way, we have a sender here and we have a receiver here. When the digital data is transferred from one place to other place, we are going to add one extra parity bit. Please remember this very thing. We are going to add extra parity bit for each data set or each data or each word, but it will be word. So what we do is, whenever we send the data from one place to other place, we are going to add an extra parity bit to each word. Okay. At the receiver side, the parity bit will be checked. And based on the parity bit results, you may end up with two results. There may be no error, there may be error indication. Okay, this is how we do it. So whenever we send, we are going to use some circuit here that is called parity generated circuit. Generation of parity. Similarly, at the receiver side, you are going to have a circuit to check the parity bit. We will discuss these circuits in the combination logic design. For the timing, you assume circuit which produces. For the timing, you remember that once there is a circuit which produces a parity bit, there is other side one more circuit which check the parity of the receiving code. Now we'll try to see how to generate the parity code for the given data. So in case of parity code, we have two types of parity codes: even parity bit or even parity code. Next one is odd parity code or odd parity bit. Okay, we simply for the reply we write it as PE, we write as PO. Okay, now we'll see for the even parity. in case of even parity, so the rule is very simple. The rule is, in a given data, in a given word, if total number of ones are even, then parity bit becomes 0. Okay, if not means total number of ones are, total number of ones are odd, parity bit becomes 1 to make total number of ones even. So it is very clear, in case of even parity, so in case of even parity we have to see how many total number of ones are given in the given word. If the number of ones are even, you don't have to keep one more one, so you just keep the parity bit as 0, so that the total number of ones in the given word is even. Suppose the given even parity, what we are going to do is, we are going to check the total number of ones in a given word. If it is even number, we are going to keep parity bit as 0. Even if you add the parity bit, the total number of ones will be even. If at all the given word having odd number of ones, you are going to add parity bit 1, so that total number of ones becomes even. For example, if we take simple example, let's take this data bit. This data you are going to transfer. So if you add the parity bit, you are going to write it as 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, because it is already having even number of ones, your parity bit becomes 0. But whereas in case of, take another example, 0, 1, 1, 1. In this case, you are having even number of ones. To make it total odd number, total number of ones even, you are going to add. Going to add 1 here, 0, 1, 1. This is your even parity bit. This will be your data bit. So this is how you are going to add the parity bit to the given data, so the total number of ones becomes, so the total number of ones becomes even. Now coming to the odd parity, now come to odd parity bit, how to you are going to add the same thing, the rule will be same. In a given data, if total number of ones are odd, then parity bit for the odd parity will be 0. For example, if you take 0, 1, 1, in this data it's already having odd number of ones, or total number of ones are odd number, so we can write as 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. So this is your data, and this is your parity bit is added. If you count the total number of ones, again odd number of ones. So, or if total number of ones are even, if total number of ones are even, in that case your odd parity bit becomes 1. For example, if you take 1, 1, 1, it is already having even number of ones, but as for the odd parity concern, we have to have odd number of ones. In order to make odd number of ones, you are going to keep your p odd part as 1, so you are going to have 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1. So this is your data bits, and this is your parity bit. If you look at the total number of ones, is again odd number. So this is how you are going to add the parity bit to the given data. Now we try to see how to check the, now we will try to see how to find the error in a given data. Let's take a simple example to understand. So having data here, let's say 4 ones is your data, and this is your sender, and this is your receiver. As I said, you have a circuit here and you have a circuit here. This circuit generates the parity, this circuit check for the parity. So now we are sending this data here first. We are inputting this data here and is transmitting from here. So before it transmitting, it has to add the parity bit. So in case of, suppose I am using, let's say, even parity. I am using even parity. I am using even parity for this transmission. So this has to be informed to the receiver. So that means he has to inform the receiver that I am using even parity. He will also keep the circuit for the even parity to check here. So when you take the even parity, you are going to get, this is having even number of ones, your parity bit becomes zero. So you are going to send the data as 0 1 1 1 1. If the receiver side receives the same number, it is going to produce your parity check circuit. A parity circuit produce no error as it receives an even number of ones. If at all, if the data becomes something like this 0, 0, 1, 1, and this is received by your receiver, and this circuit, what is the circuit as I said, this circuit will now check for the total number of ones. The total number of ones is odd, but the sender already said we are sending information even parity, and we have received the odd number of ones. That means there is a error in the signal. There is an error in the data. Okay, this is how we do it, finding error. So now we'll take the same example with the odd parity also. Let's take, now you are sending data with odd parity. Let's take this your sender and this your receiver. Your circuit here to check the parity, it's circuit for the to generate the parity. Now we are sending, let's say, 4 ones. Since having even number of ones, your parity bit for the odd will becomes 1, because to make the total number of ones odd, so you are going to say send the data, the parity bit will be 1 2 3 4 5, so total 5 number of ones. If it receives same, it produces no error. Okay, but if it receives with a slight change, the receiving side, suppose if it receives something like this instead of that, now your received data having even number of ones, but as already informed by sender that he is sending by odd parity. Now your circuit will check for the odd parity. It found even number of ones are available, then it produce a error stating that there is a error in the data. This is how we perform the detection of the error. Now coming to the limitation, what is the limitation? If more than one bit error is there in a given word, your parity circuit will not produce any error. Let's take a simple example. Let's say you are sending this data 1 1 1. So after adding parity bit, you are going to add parity bit. Let's assume you are sending data with the even parity. Now you are going to add 0 1 1 1 1. This is your parity and this is your data. Now it is sending through a channel to the receiver side. Now receiver side is received something like this 0 1 0 0 1. Now the circuit, whatever I said, the parity detecting circuit or parity checking circuit will check for the number of ones. It is having even number of ones and it produces no error, because the data which you received having even number of ones, so it doesn't produce any error. So this happens only when two bits are changed. If you look at here, this bit is changed to 0 and this bit also changed to 0. As a result, you are getting the even number of ones with